Well, Lisa Miller wrote this week's Newsweek cover story on mama grizzlies, Hear Them Growl, and she joins us now to talk about it. Thanks so much.
I'm happy to be here. Thanks.
So it's interesting, when we saw that ad out there, I mean, it's a well-produced political ad. You almost think she was running for something, but really she's sort of been the kingmaker, not the king herself.
That's right, or the queen, or the grizzly maker.
Right, the queen maker. Explain what she's trying to get across with this mama grizzly phenomenon and who.
Right. She's anointing female candidates, female Republican candidates who sort of stand for what she stands for. And it's this kind of anti-establishment, small government, no taxes approach to, you know, saying everything's wrong in Washington.
What is the imagery, though, that you're conjuring up when you say grizzly?
Right. It's a maternal image. It's a primal maternal image. It's saying, like, we're women, we're moms, we know when there's something wrong with America, and we're going to fight back because we're going to do everything we can to protect our cubs. You know, it's this anti-establishment fury rooted in the maternal instinct, you know, in the women's instinct.
It's interesting because when you take a look at some of the candidates she's referring to, and we can talk about some of them, they aren't necessarily all on the same page with each other.
That's right.
When it comes to some of these issues, I mean, is this sort of a coherent set of ideas, or is it more of a marketing tool?
Right. Well, I mean, I would say, and we say at the end of the story, that it is really more of a marketing tool. It's a very compelling image, right? Everybody who's a parent has that feeling of wanting to protect their kids. And if we make it America's kids or our kids, you know, our future, it's a very powerful image. On the other hand, you know, Christine O'Donnell, for example, isn't a mom. So she talks about our grandchildren in speeches, but she's not actually a mama grizzly.
Is there a Democratic equivalent to the mama grizzly phenomenon on the other side?
Well, I mean, I think, you know, you could call Hillary Clinton a mama grizzly, right? She's a powerful woman, she's a mom, but I don't think she would ever call herself a mama grizzly. She doesn't fit into this demographic.
You wrote an interesting line at the end of the article that said, in the wild, real mama grizzlies are known to be aggressive, irrational, and mean. The issues facing the country are complex and bears are not. So what is the upshot of this?
Well, I mean, I think, you know, it's a great marketing tool, as we said at the outset. You know, calling on women's primal maternal instincts is a good thing, but let's think about it. I mean, this is a very divided country, and we have some big problems to solve. Do we really want bears to solve our problems?
Well, it's some people who are looking for a job will say, hey, I'll take anything at this point, but you bring up a lot of good points in the article. I'm glad you joined us. Lisa Miller, senior editor at Newsweek. Great to talk to you.
Very happy to be here.
John?
You ever run face-to-face with a grizzly? It can be anything it wants to be.